इनवाइट प्लीज सर।
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وكفى وعلى رسوله المصطفى وعلى آله المستقبلين الشرفاء، أما بعد، Honorable Chair of the Session، other distinguished dignitaries on and off the dais, most beloved delegates from various parts of the country, dear colleagues, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I take this opportunity, first of all, to welcome you all to the second day of the program, Tricentennial SKS of National Delegates Conference. Alhamdulillah, this is not the first event of its kind. I hope this is the third event we are conducting. SKS have been conducted all over the world. Or over the country. First of this type of event was in, I think, around 2000 in Mumbai, way back. Then another conference, I think, in 2012. It was conducted in 2012. And alhamdulillah, we already reached over here. This is the third conference within the span of 30 years, we could manage three national conferences. Day by day, we are trying to spread our wings all over India through various educational, social activities. May Almighty Allah help our activities. We may pray for that. Today, in this fine morning, we are going to discuss about the Muslim India, the way forward. From day one, yesterday onwards, we have been discussing various issues related to the minorities, especially Muslims in the country. Yesterday, the morning session was on inclusive India. In post-legislative section, we were discussing about the social justice and the constitution of India. Right now, we are in the seminar of, yes, what are the way forward? We have to think it in a deeper sense. Of course, we have a lot of issues, burning issues in front of us. Some of the forces there are trying to cover, they are trying to hide the contributions of Muslim to the country. As we know, Muslims in India have been an integral part of this nation since the medieval history. Contributions of Muslim for the nation building are numerous, like the mighty architecture, civilizational innovations, and outstanding sacrifices of life and property in the anti-British freedom struggle. History of medieval era is rich with the mighty architecture and literary contributions of Delhi Sultanate and Mughal Empire. In the modern Indian history, Muslims have made exceptional struggle against the European colonialism. More than half a million of Muslims have sacrificed their life during the 1857 revolt. The tragic incident of partition was the most painful incident in the Muslim history of India. The secular strength of India, which defeated the British Empire, was seriously damaged due to the partition. Although we Indian Muslims fought together for freedom, we started fighting each other when we got freedom on a narrow principle of partition. At the same time, it has to be noted that a great number of Muslims stayed back. Hello. So no one can deny, refuse the contributions of Muslims to Indian culture. Greater number of Muslims stayed back in secular India than those migrated in theoretical theocratic Pakistan. Many stopped their migration midway when Mahatma Gandhi guaranteed all Indian Muslims an honorable existence in New India in his message to Muslims through All India Radio. However, Indian Muslims at present are passing through the toughest time of their history. The government at the center does nothing other than formulating attracting slogans. Modi ji is always saying, "Sabke saath, sabke vikas, sabke vishwas." Kinke saath, kinke vishwas. We have to think about it. The ground reality is miserably different with multiple incidents with emanates for among the community. It's undeniable that recent incidents of multiple mob lynching, abrogation of Article 370. And the consequent denial of fundamental rights for Indian citizens in Kashmir, large number of citizenship exclusion, especially in the most Muslim dominant lower part of Assam, have created certain amount of fear and anxiety among Muslim community. The fear is analyzed similar to those in the aftermath of Babri Masjid demolition and the post-Godhra riots in Gujarat. Moreover, the context of 17th Lok Sabha election has added more to this fear. Unlike earlier elections, this time the community has literally been deserted by all so-called politicians, political secular parties. Even in the Congress manifesto for 2019 Lok Sabha, they did not mention the Muslim minority term even once. And other so-called politicians, political parties refrain from talking about Muslims during their election campaigns. At the same time, India is a country with one of the best contributions in the world with freedom of religion, equity before law, due process of law and judicial review. For the Muslim minority, yes, we are facing so many issues right now. It's a time, high time. We have to think what are the ways forward, how we can sustain. So the first solutions, of course, in this session, the session is especially designed, as rightly mentioned by our honorable coordinators. Yes, this session is especially designed, inshallah. After this session, we may formulate an action plan, how to go ahead, how to march ahead. Of course, we have so many problems, but we are trying to find it out. We are trying to sort it out one by one. The first solution, as we know, yes, we have to have our faith in our faith and confidence in our constitution. And another one, we can see the solution as in our last discussion, it was suggested that, of course, only the way out is the educational empowerment of Muslim society, Muslim community from the grassroots level. I am not giving all the solution, but for setting the context, creating the context, I am just giving the outline. And also we know what happened in many countries, hate campaign is on. Even between the hate campaign, we have to undertake some interfaith interactions, dialogues, so that so many non-Muslims, they can understand Islam. So hopefully the hate campaign, as we know what happened in the Europe, it will be a positive towards the Muslim community. And also this is the high time to uphold the unity of Muslim community. We are Ummatun Wahida. We have to uphold that message of unity. And also, finally, we have to spread the Kerala model of Muslim empowerment. That is the major crux of these discussions. We know we have a model with us. What happened in Kerala? We are discussing various issues in various seminar and academic debates, discourses. Then they are asking, yes, what happened in Kerala? How you Kerala people are doing? Well, okay, yes, this is the high time you have to look into the Kerala, what happened. We have to discuss in detail the Kerala model of Muslim empowerment. The first thing, as we know, as Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned, there is a sinfani min ummati, idha salha salha an-nasu kulluhum. وَإِذَا فَسَدَ فَسَدَ النَّاسُ كُلُّهُمْ الْعُلَمَاءُ وَالْأُمَرَاءُ. The close nexus, the close connections between ulama, umara, that was the total, that was the story behind the success of Kerala Muslim. So we have to understand and underline the principle, yes, the close connection between ulama and umara. And second thing, as we know, the political activism, what we are practicing in Kerala, and also the largest educational network, including madrasas, Arabic colleges, various educational institutions. These are the major highlights we can understand from the Kerala model of Muslim empowerment. This, inshallah, we can spread the message of Kerala Muslim empowerment to the various states. Of course, inshallah, we can take this and this is a, this as a model for the empowerment of Muslim community in India. Of course, we have a galaxy of eminent personalities with us. So just I am welcoming all of our guests to the program. As announced, Syed Sadiq Ali Shihab Tangal Panakkad, the former president of SKSSF and the latest winner of Rajiv Gandhi Youth Foundation Award, I welcome Syed Sadiq Ali Shihab Tangal with all due respect to the program. He will be giving the inaugural address of the session. Sir, I welcome you to this function. Dr. Muhammad Bahauddin Nadvi, there is no need of much introduction, Vice Chancellor of Darul Huda, he will be chairing the session. Along with that, we have our eminent, vibrant presence in Lok Sabha, Dr. E.T. Muhammad Bashir Sahab, our leader. He will be giving the keynote address of this session. And we have eminent personalities like President of All India Muslim Majlis-e Mushawara, Navid Hamid Sahab. He will be giving the remarks as chief guest. We have former Pro Vice Chancellor of IGNO, Dr. Bashir Ahmad Khan Sahab. He is an eminent personality, as you know. He will be giving a lecture. along with we have Maulana Abdul Mateen, General Secretary All India, Sunnat al Jamia, Jamaat West Bengal. We have Maulana Noorul Huda Noor, President West Bengal Ulama Parishad. We have Haseeb Ahmed Ansari, Maharashtra. Muhammad Anis Abbasi, Rajasthan. Muhammad Rais Ahmed, Manipur. Firoz Bashir Khan, Rajasthan. Abbas Alam Siddiqui, Bihar. We have various representatives from various parts of the country. I welcome on behalf of SKSF, I welcome you all to this function. We are here at Awane Ghalib. I wish to submit a couplet, Sitaryom Se Aage, Jaham Aur Bhi Hai. Abhi Ishq Ki Imtihan Aur Bhi Hai. Sitaryom Se Aage, Jaham Aur Bhi Hai. Abhi Ishq Ki Imtihan Aur Bhi Hai. With these couplets, again, once again, I welcome all of you to the function. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.